Hello. My name is Anton Weiss. The movie you are about to experience explores the depths of human depravity. It plots the course of a man driven to the brink of insanity by a lust for vengeance. It'll be painful. It'll be violent. Viewer discretion is advised.
Each of us is a story. The dreamer, the lover, the robber, the killer, the scientist, the creator, the fighter. Together, we inhabit this planet.
That's me. I live on the rails. It's a good life. I like it. Some people call me hobo, but I don't like to go by that name. I find food and water where I can get it. It isn't really that hard to find. You know where to look. That bow on my back? Bet you're wondering about that. Well, the thing is, I don't carry any arrows because I don't have any to carry. Bow's the last thing I have to remember my family by. But it's really more extra weight that I have to carry. Every few days or so, I sharpen and refine the point on this stick. Works mighty fine for defending myself, though I can't say I ever had to defend myself.
Besides, if I need to find anything out here, you know that thing I've been carrying around that looks remarkably like a flashlight? It's actually a heat gun I use to find my squirrels and rabbits when I do get hungry. It measures the heat levels, and I saved up and bought myself a fancy-dancy feature that lets it talk to me. No screens to read off of. It's really remarkable technology.
Not too worried about anything out here except one local legend. It's called the G Train, and legend has it if you walk out on the rails at the wrong time, and he's feeling particularly hungry, you ain't gonna see your family again.
Engaging system. Target acquisition system ready. Error, no target found. Please re-enter. 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 Target found. Run.
nothing here. Oh. And it started to rain. I think I just heard the train. Come on, let's go. You heard that? Let's go. We gotta go.
Too.
Oh, how are you?
Doing great. How about you?
I'm good, thanks.
That's great. Where's Griffin at?
He's relieving himself. He'll be here in a moment.
I mean, it's been crazy. We're going all the way up and down the Shenandoah Valley.
It must be tough.
It is.
Father? Son! I missed you. Mother!
You just saw me.
What?
So how you been? I haven't seen you in 17 years. It's been rough. I mean, those northern people up in the north trying to take away the slaves, man. You can't.
That's a bit of a
mistake. Oh, really? You know, your great granddaddy, he owned one down, he owned a plantation down in South Carolina. My God, it's only been a month, but it feels like 17 years since I last saw y'all.
It really does.
It sure does.
Hey, what's wrong, Griffin? You seem a little nervous there.
You know, just life on the rails is really tough on you. Stretches your mind further than it should go.
Nah, I thought you were having some girl troubles. I was about to say, you need help.
No, I haven't seen any girls.
Oh, really? That's a shame. Yeah. Then what have you been doing for the last month?
Smuggling.
Fine business nowadays?
Well, not really, right?
There hasn't been anything around.
I mean, my friend Han, he can help with some things.
That's good.
Yeah, he has a big dog named Chewy.
What does he do? How can he help?
See, he's on the down low.
Mm.
He's one of those people.
Got it.
So, what's for dinner?
Well, we have a candle.
Alright, we can do that. We can cut up in sections. Your finger first. You seem famished.
Thanks. Hey, what's for dinner?
I smuggled a can of beans out of the food cart.
Oh, great. Okay, I'll get this. Did you hear that?
Yes. Alright, everyone get quiet. Get quiet.
Thank you.
car! Go!
Maybe not tomorrow. Someday. A rabbit. I am hungry and I should eat it. There it goes. I must find food or I will surely perish. Who is that? Maybe he can help. Hey. Hello? Why, hello there. I'm so hungry.
So naturally you think I can provide you with food?
Please.
Where are you from, boy? Where are your parents?
Well... So I can't live on the rails anymore, and I'm a terrible hunter.
Right. Follow me.
Wait. Can I ask you something? I need to kill him.
Who?
That man with the bandana. It's just...
What is it?
He's too advanced, and I'm just a kid. And he's probably long gone by now anyway.
What if I knew where he is?
You know where he is? Where is he?
Release me!
Not until you tell me where he is.
patience, and we can strike a deal.
What kind of deal?
I have targets. Bad men that need to be killed.
Tell me their names and locations, and I'll take them all out.
That's a good way to get yourself shot. No. No. I will train you. I will teach you everything I know. Then, maybe you'll have a chance. If you kill these men, I'll tell you where he is.
When do we start?
Do you know how to fight?
Yes.
Wake up!
Get over here. To strike an enemy down, it is necessary that you are precise, know where you aim. Stay true. Do not move. Do not intend to hit. Look at your enemy. Look through him. See through his skin. See his muscles, his bones, and his nerves. Analyze him completely and wholly. Use this to find his weakness and then strike. Only then do you strike. Put this flame out without blowing or striking the candle with anything.
Aw, oh, man.
Thank you.
Your first target is an arms dealer. He's very dangerous and you have to be very, very quiet. His shepherds don't like company. Your next target is a farmer. It's best if you take him out from a distance.
I wonder how my potatoes are gonna end up this year. What? No. No! What? I waited 12 years for those potatoes to grow. But they're not potatoes! I didn't mean for this to happen to me. Tell my chicken, Margaret, I love her. I didn't mean to leave you alone. No! Don't leave me! No!
Your final target is a Confederate general posing as a man. She's very crafty and highly skilled. Be careful, young one. Report back to me when you're finished. Thank you.
Don't turn around. Thank you.
Hello. I'm sure at this point in the film, you're all very confused, so allow me to clarify. During the Civil War, the Lincoln administration hired a man by the name of Anton Weiss to spearhead a government program known as the Union Super Soldier Program. The two test subjects, Griffin and Brian, have escaped the lab. Griffin, writing a letter to his mentor, promised to avenge his family. However, a man plagued by vengeance often blurs the line between that and justice. Soon, you will understand just how far to the brink of insanity the lust for vengeance can drive a broken and vulnerable man. Soon, you will witness a series of events so horrifying and so gruesome that they could only be carried out by a man who has completely lost touch with reality. Viewer discretion is advised.
I was exploring the library at Haverford when I found it. Traces of it, anyway. Seemingly random clues, coordinates, riddles, and enigmas. Soon I found out what it really was all about. It was a medical journal published by the scientists that created Griffin and I. Resurrected us, more like. They intended for us to be indestructible. Nothing can kill us, save one device. They discovered a failsafe somewhere in Nicaragua, a device created by our ancestors, so powerful that it still remains hidden today. Together the pieces of the puzzle that were between the lines of the medical journal, the silver lining waiting for me to discover it. At first, it was a fun game, tormenting Griffin, chasing him, killing him. I grow tired of it, but no, he will not stop unless I finish him. I have followed these clues to this remote desert jungle where both the scientists and I believe that this ancient power lies. It is the only thing that can destroy us. If I find it, when I find it, I must take great care. The legend states that each second it spends in full sunlight, the device loses its power.
Thank you.
You there?
Yeah, I'm here. I was just about to head home. Why, what's up?
Yeah, we got a call in about some campers. They're lost. They have no idea where they are. They radioed us in.
Oh, geez, we better get to them quick. You know that creep's been prowling around in the woods around here. Any idea what sector he might be in?
Yeah, they're over by 23.
Any report on the snow drifts, or do I have to take that ATV?
It's getting pretty bad out there. I think you should take the ATV out.
Copy that. I'm leaving right now. Just tell them to hold on. It's getting dark. I'm going to try and get to them as quickly as I can. And tell them to keep an eye out. We can't forget that that guy's hanging out around here. We've lost too many already.
Copy that. We'll do. One lost camper's too many.
You got that right. I hope you're ready for a late night. I'm going there now. I'll raid you when I get there. Dispatch, I think I found the location. There's a lot of footprints here. It looks like there was a scuffle. A few young kids, and you're not going to like this, but an adult male.
What do you see? I mean, are they still there? Like, what's going on? You okay?
You are not going to like this. I followed the footprints. There's bodies here. A lot of blood.
You better get out of there, man. There's a snowdrift heading your way.
I hear what you're saying, but I don't feel right about this, leaving these two bodies here. I feel like these kids deserve more than that. I hope that guy still isn't hanging out around here. I'm getting really, really nervous. I feel like I'm hearing footsteps and the snow crunching. I know it's just my imagination, or maybe the falling snow, but I feel like somebody's watching me. I can't hear what you're saying, but there's something else out here. I know it's late, but I know everybody else went home, but can you please send somebody else out here? I'm getting really freaked out. There is someone else out here. I hear them.
Look, I'm really sorry, man, but nobody else is gonna be here. Or until dawn.
Is this Sheriff Rhymes of Lelandville County?
Yes, it is. Who am I speaking with?
This is the Vice President. As you know, you are the only law officer within the entire county. As your file says, that's because earlier in your career, you were put in charge of a unit and they all died. It says that your short-sightedness led to the death of over 14 law officers. Is that correct?
Yes, please stop reminding me of it. What do you need?
Well, seeing as the Supreme Court decided your exile punishment was enough, the President and I have decided to recall your punishment due to the recent murders in your town.
Murders? What murders?
You're kidding, right?
No! What murders?
A young man dressed as a train conductor is the prime suspect for the murder of 12 children in your town. Are you telling me that you aren't investigating this?
No, absolutely not at all what I'm telling you. I have all my men on as we speak.
We've just been through this. You don't have any men to command. Forget it. I'm calling to tell you that we're revoking your sentence temporarily. If even one man dies on your watch, you can say goodbye to that badge, Sheriff. As of now, we're sending a mixed unit of detectives and SWAT officers to your police station with directions to drive as fast as they can.
Ma'am, I don't have a police station. I'm in a public library.
Well, I will redirect them to meet you at the scene. I have instructed them to all tune their walkie-talkies to Channel 3. You can command them from there. The FBI just got a tip-off from an anonymous source that there is a hostage situation with two men on Tattletown Road. One of them is our suspect. Outside of the building, you will find a transport plane, but we couldn't afford a pilot. You can still fly one, yes?
No. Of course, like riding a bike.
Great. I'm instructing you to fly to the scene where your fellow officers will meet you. You are to take charge of them and apprehend both men. Alive. No bullets should be fired. No loss of life on either side.
No guns.
Sheriff, this was your downfall last time. Remember, if anyone dies, you're losing your job for good. And make sure you don't damage another one of our planes. Good luck. You'll need it.
Luck is my middle name.
Hello, Griffin. You like my little toy I built? It's got over 300 rounds just for you.
You're the one that killed all those kids. I'm calling 911 on you.
Oh no, the cops are here.
Am I cleared for takeoff? Wait, I'm the captain. Of course I am.
Thank you. I want you to block off two streets in every direction. I want your people ready to move.
What?
I want Snipe Team Number 1 to cover all my uniforms from the entire vantage point and take a fight. I want SWAT Team Number 2 to cover every street facing due south. Go. And hit anything that moves.
Sit, I have something to tell you.
How'd you find me? Who are you?
We are at a reservation, one of the few protected lands. I am an Earthwalker, one of the people of this planet. I want to speak with you because I see you are struggling with this world. I myself am troubled. There is a battle taking place inside of me. Will you listen? It is a fight between two wolves, and it is a terrible fight. One wolf is evil. He is pride, lies, superiority, guilt, envy, anger, sorrow, resentment, and revenge. And the other is good. He is humility, truth, empathy, generosity, compassion, kindness, love, peace, serenity, and justice. We know that the same fight is happening inside you. We beg that you stop the killing. It is happening inside each of us.
Wait. Which wolf will win?
The one you feed.
Man, I sure could go for an ice-cold Coca-Cola. Are you thirsty like me? Well, you should try our concession stand and buy a can of Coca-Cola.
Can we have Pepsi? Is Pepsi okay?
Come on, I knew this would happen. Why didn't we just use a DVD player? Oh, let me just put this here. Alright. Well, all the film is... Oh, Jesus, some fucking fire! Oh, God. Let me just get the fire extinguisher. Okay. 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 Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Where are the blankets? Where are the blankets? Oh, the blankets made it worse. The blankets made it worse. I should have known. Oh my God, this is awful. This is one of the worst things ever. Okay, I'm gonna get the DVD player. Oh, phew. Okay, we fixed it. Back to the movie.
Those are letters from the town's people. God.
Letters about what?
Those letters are from the townspeople. And I'm going to write back to each and every one of them, telling them who I am to get them on my side. To kill Griffin. That's what those letters are for. I'm even going to get that sheriff on my side. Yeah.
You're telling me you're going to read all of these?
You're darn tootin' I am.
That's too Western.
Too Western? I think it's too Western.
See that hat? It's not scary.
What? It's just my desert hat. Okay, I'll change the hats later.
Okay,
that'll be fine.
Okay.
Okay. But yeah, I'm gonna read all the letters. I'm gonna write back to them.
Good, because I'm not.
Okay. I didn't need your help anyway, so it's fine.
Alright, cool. I'm gonna go take my break now.
They're gonna be super. Okay.
I'm gonna go now.
Okay. Some music.
I could play chopsticks.
I could really use some music. Give me something more exciting.
Okay.
Who's back?
Now! I have an idea. Come with me. Here.
Sweet mixtape.
I need you to dance in the background.
I'll get paid enough for this job.
I swear I'm gonna kill her.
I came in like a wreck. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know we used to be bad.
It's Britney, bitch.
She
Wake me up.
The Fitness Gram Pacer Test is a multi-stage aerobic capacity test that progressively gets more difficult.
Folks call me Brian, that's my name. I don't have money and I don't have faith, no. I don't think you know me, so let me give you my backstory and elaborate. Perhaps you'll want to collaborate. Born in Chicago in 1838, but it didn't make sense, fool. I'm immortal, didn't fall through a portal. I'm a victim of a terrible experiment. The pain was barely bearable. Maybe worth more than I was worth at my birth. But let me back up and show you the glory of my rich and death backstory. I grew up dirt poor. My family couldn't even afford a front door. One day they all got sick. The blood ran thick. They got tuberculosis and mononucleosis. I was the only one in good health, but the meds stayed on the shelf. We couldn't afford it. So while they were sick, I went on a trip to a hospital. The window was brittle, so I smashed it. It went to my head, I took some meds. What'd I take? Tylenol, Z-Quil. That's it, the doctors had a fit. I walked in and I said shalom to my home. So now I can't die, you see. But neither can he. He went through the same thing as me. Tried to rob a kid, and not to my delight, he put up one hell of a fight. Now he's attacked you. Time to get him what's due. If we work together, we can tar and feather. We have to end him just like he ended little Tim.
I mean, Griffin can't be that bad. You just sang a whole song about him. Yeah. Wait,
how dare you question my cause? How dare you side with Griffin? After all the work I've put into this!
At this point in the film, you may be confused once again. So,
hey! Get off your phone!
You may be confused, so allow me to elaborate. Brian has now written letters to every member of the town, including the sheriff, in hopes of assembling something of a militia bent on Griffin's destruction. I would also like to point out that the motivation behind Brian's actions is not bloodlust or vengeance, but amusement. Griffin's torment is Brian's entertainment. That's all I have to say for now.
Thank you.
Jess? Jess?
Hello, Griffin. I see that you have left your precious girlfriend unattended. Unfortunately for you, I'm what we call an opportunist. I've taken advantage of the situation at hand, and I have your girl. Why am I doing this? For the look on your face, to avenge those poor little kids you've murdered. I'm at the maintenance shed on this very property. There has to be a map of the area somewhere around here, but you better hurry. You've got about 3 minutes to, like, blow her brains out. Also, I've rigged this envelope with either anthrax or cocaine. You'll find out in about a second.
Hey! probably cocaine.
She's dead, though. Truly dead.
What's happening?
Something is happening. Beauty's at work through pure and selfless acceptance, through everyday transcendence that remedies the chaos, an antidote to the sorrow on this earth for eternity.
Well, I am sad.
Music hurts so deeply that it does not hurt at all.
I love music. He had to take the one thing that I had left away from me. She was beautiful.
Seen from a distance, almost everything looks beautiful.
She was always up close, not at a distance. You don't think I'm romanticizing her, do you?
As the distance increases, the more we romanticize.
You know, it's weird that you would say that. I'm having trouble picturing her far away. I can just see her up close, her hazel eyes reflecting in the sun. It's the small details you remember, I guess.
All the small details from the everyday reminisces the past. Because things we want to forget are the things we can never forget.
I don't want to forget her, though. I want to remember her and use what I learned with her to figure out what to do next. Wish my dad was here. He would have a story to tell me about everything. After these stories, I would just know what to do. Maybe you could tell me a story, and then I'll know what to do.
As I'm walking, I see you on your motorbike. I can see your blue eyes and nose peering underneath the crash helmet.
You know, I've never ridden on a motorcycle before.
But it's not you, it's just a man that looks like you. I'm disappointed every time.
Why? You don't even know me.
Every time I see a man on a motorbike, I think it's my dad.
That's really weird.
I'm not sure why this is. Sometimes I forget what your bike looks like.
Again, I've never even ridden a bike before.
Everyone's eyes and faces look the same underneath black crash helmets.
I'm telling you, it wasn't me.
From a distance, everyone looks like you. Although soon I realize it's not. I remember you used to paint pictures of naked women in crash helmets.
How did you know that?
Their identities were hidden too. I always wondered who these women were. Their shiny black round heads like lollipops. Props. Who were they, Dad?
Okay, that story didn't help me at all. I know that Native lady said not to be violent, and to try and be as peaceful as much as I can. I mean, I was violent when I killed everyone at the camp, and that kind of worked. Maybe violence is the answer. Should I kill him?
Do it! Just do it!
Should I kill him?
Don't let your dreams be dreams.
All right, I'll do it tomorrow.
Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Just do it!
I just don't think it would be successful.
Some people dream of success while you're gonna wake up and work hard at it!
I mean, he's so strong and he's such a good fighter. It's impossible.
Nothing is impossible!
Maybe you're right. He doesn't have an army anymore. It'll just be me and him. I wish I could move away and quit, but I know he'll just follow me.
You should get to the point where anyone else would quit, and you're not gonna stop there! No! What are you waiting for?
The right opportunity? Or should I just do it?
Do it! Just do it!
I still don't think I can do it. I'm not strong enough.
Yes, you can! Just do it!
I'm just afraid I'll ruin it, and I'll have to start all over again.
and wake up 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 and wake up.
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go. The bottom of your glass, hoping one day you'll make a dream last. But dreams come slow and they go so fast. You see it when you close your eyes. Maybe one day you'll understand why everything you touch surely dies. But you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. Staring at the ceiling in the dark, same old empty feeling in your heart. Cause love comes slow and it goes so fast. Well, you see her when you fall asleep, but never to touch and never to keep. Cause you loved her too much and you dive too deep. Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go. Burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
You showed me something. Something nobody else was capable of. You showed me that we all have a capacity to love. And you showed me this world is more unforgiving than I had ever thought. This world, it rips you apart. At birth, we are given people to love, only for them to be taken away from us. When the blood stops flowing, when the scars heal, we accept another into ourselves. Only for it to happen once more. Know that your death is not in vain. With it comes power. No attachments, nothing to slow me down. I will not stop. I will not sleep. I will hunt him and every last one of his comrades down until the streets flow with blood. I am not ignorant. I know that the battle between him and I will never end, but I have to try. I have to avenge you and my family. I lust for vengeance and I will have it. I have nothing left to lose.
Can't wait to kick off my retirement with a nice fire. I'm glad I got fired. What's that there, then? I guess it was a flay.
This is too easy. I'm ready to get creative. Thank you.
Oh, something's a little bit fishy. Oh, at least nothing of my stuff got tampered with.
Yeah, I keep hearing things, don't you know? This is perfect. I'll attach this sparkler to this carabiner, attach it to the string, let it dangle, light the sparkler, it will trail down, him none the wiser, and ignite the gasoline trap.
Stupid and dumb, it looks like torture.
not best me!
Get your sword first.
Aha! I kill you right now. You think this is funny?
Hey, bud.
Joke?
I'll leave you alone. You never have to see me again.
Brian said the same thing. And almost a century later, he is still tormenting me. No loose ends. I already finished off the rest of his army. Now it's just you and him.
Wait, how are you gonna kill him if he's invincible?
Unlike him, I have something to fight for. I'll beat him till he's dead!
What then?
What do you think you're doing? What then? What then? Then my wife and I will finally be free. Once he is in the ground, we will move somewhere up north and start a new life. Maybe Maine or New Hampshire. But first, I have to kill you. Then, me and my wife will kill Brian. Ah.
Thank you.
killed my family, you killed my girlfriend, and now I've killed your lieutenant and your militia.
The game is over.
This is a game to you?
Whoa.
You know what this is? This is the only thing that can kill us. This is from ancient times said to be the only thing that can kill us. Game is over, Griffin. Come on out. I'm your mentor! What? You can't be! That's not possible. I saw your obituary in the newspaper. I killed your family and Jess. I did it all for fun. But now, I'm done. I'm gonna kill you once and for all.
With your death, I am free.
Griffin, you fool! Nothing can kill us but the artifact!
Free. The game is over. Griffin is dead. I'm dumping all my stuff, and I'm done.
Mm-hmm.